Hello fellow game creators, in this video I will explain how to make Space Invaders in Clickton Fusion 2.5 with ease. We will start a new application, change the window size in the properties menu. I will use 1920 by 1080. Click on the frame to change the background color to black. Now you need to open your frame. You can resize the frame by holding Alt and scrolling your mouse wheel. Double click on the window of the frame to create a new active object, and click anywhere afterwards to position it. Double click on the player to open its properties. I will import the image of the player into the sprite editor. And in the properties menu, select the movement tab and add in the 8 direction movements. Deselect all of the directions and select the left and the right arrow. Was easy, right? You already fixed the movement of the player. Let's make the game more interesting. We will add in the enemies. Double click on the window to make the enemy as an active object and open its sprite editor. Drag in the sprite you like for the first frame and add another animation frame for the other sprite, just to add in basic animation. Then select the direction options for the animation. Set the animation speed to 100 and make it loop. Click with your right mouse on the alien and make it to duplicate in 6 rows and 26 columns. We will assign the invader moving settings, and all is set for the enemy. As an extra touch, we can remake the obstacles in the same way we did with the alien. So, by making a duplicate. Just delete some of the blocks to get the shape you like. Then use the standard function of copy and paste to add some more barricades in the scene. Now we want to create an object for the bullet of the player. You can resize the shell in the sprite editor. For the bullets, I would suggest making the height twice as high as the width. Then, copy the bullet of the player and select another color for the shell of the enemy. Rename all the objects and move the bullets outside of the frame. Open the event editor. First, we like the player to shoot. To make this work, we just need to create a new condition and select with our right mouse the function click the mouse pointer in keyboard settings and select the key press and hit the space bar to select the space bar for launching the bullet. Now, as the function has been created, we can click on the box below the spaceship and choose again with the right mouse button the function launch on objects. Select the bullet and give it a speed of 100 and make it move upward. To make it work, we only just need to collide the bullet with the alien. Open a new condition, select the player and its collision with another object and select the alien. In the event manager, select destroy the alien and the player bullet. We do exactly the same with the collision between the player bullet and the enemy bullet and the barricade. Now we want to restart the game when all the aliens are destroyed. Make a new condition on the alien. Choose pick and count and click on all aliens have been destroyed function. In its storyboard controls, we will select restart the application. Okay, so we want to make the aliens shoot at random every second. So make the condition of alien pick at unexpected and add with the insert another timer of 1 second. In the manager, we let the alien launch a button in the same way as we did with the player. Only this time we make the bullet move downward. Before fixing the collision with the player, I like to add in the lives. So go back to your frame and create a lives object. Super easy, right? In the same way, we can add a score object. It is a tiny bit annoying that the score has been saved as a standard PNG image set, but you can recolor them with the paint buckets tool. I just realized that the bullets I created are huge, so I will resize them to 16 by 32. Go back to the event editor, and in the collide with the player and the enemy condition, we will also subtract the player's life with 1. You also need to create a new condition that if player 1's number of lives reach 0, then we want to restart the application on the storyboard. On the condition of the collision between the player bullet and the alien, you can add the score to give feedback to the player. And at last, we will create a new condition to check if the alien reached your base by testing its position and only selecting the arrow on the button. In that case, we also restart the application in the storyboard. Feel free to play around with all the new stuff you learned in this tutorial. Let me know if you enjoyed this tutorial and leave some love. This was A-Create, the channel for game tutorials and more. See you in the next one. Create more, enjoy more.